you're looking at is one of my quadriplegics. So this is a fellow who was in the hospital, and I shared his picture not so much because of the quadriplegic healing, although I've seen literally like an army of quadriplegics being able to get up and walk. But the reason I wanted to share his testimony is he's a pain testimony. So most of these patients in the hospital, they're in the ICUs, and as you can see, he's hooked up to a ventilator, so you know he's getting assisted breathing. He's in his bed. You can see there's all kinds of stuff wrapped around his arm. He's, you know, he's getting IVs and lots of stuff. What I wanted to share with him is the pain issue, because when I'm in the churches, pain is one of the most common things that people come to us for. It doesn't matter if you're a cancer patient or you have arthritis or you have various kinds of autoimmune disease. Pain is just a really common issue. If I ask in a church how many people have pain, lots and lots of hands go up. In fact, most of the hands go up. The two things we see the most in the medical field, doesn't matter what the actual illness is pain and then fatigue, and then emotional issues. Doesn't matter what the origin is, this is really common symptoms. He was an interesting case because I was there visiting him to pray with him, and the nurse came in. It was time for his pain meds. He was on heavy duty opiate pain medication because he had been in a car crash. The problem that he ran into is the nurse told him they could not give him any pain medication because that kind of a substitute fill-in doctor that night, and they told this poor guy was they couldn't read his handwriting. They couldn't read the doctor's handwriting. They said, we've called him, he's on call, we're trying to get in touch with him, but we cannot give you any pain meds till we contact him, because we don't know exactly what the dose should be. We don't want to overdose you. We want to give you the right thing that the doctor's prescribed. And the nurse said, I can't make that decision. He was just absolutely crushed. He was literally begging the nurse. He was in so much pain. And she really was apologetic. She said, there's nothing I can do. We're trying to get in touch with the doctor. So the nurse went out of the room, and I'm here with this guy, and he's just crying and sobbing. And I just thought, oh, I just prayed to God. I said, dear Lord, please help this man. We really need to do something, because he's miserable. He was absolutely, it was a crisis for him, because the pain was seriously terrible. From the medical side, I know how pain is regulated in the brain and in the body, so I could pray into that with a lot of knowledge. So I prayed for him, and praise God, he falls asleep. And the next thing I know, they're snoring. And I was really happy because God had given him a very nice healing on the spot. He was able to sleep. And the wonderful thing about this is that he did what I've seen a number of patients do when they receive this kind of medical spiritual prayer in the hospitals. He was able to wean off the pain meds very quickly. I've seen some patients do this that I would have never thought could do this. But he weaned off the pain meds, and he was able to be on just very minimal dosage. So he was a wonderful case history. And when I work with cases like this, I never really am concerned about, can people heal? I work with such hard cases in places like these hospital ICUs that I've seen that, again, God can heal everything. You know, unless he wants to take you to heaven to be with him, there's nothing God can't heal.